Hello mga kabaro, kung bago ko pa lang sa channel ko, please don't forget to subscribe and click the notification bell.
We will start with the most important component of the system, an auxiliary boiler, which is provided with a burner arrangement to heat water and to generate steam. Hot well or cascade tank, which is a dedicated tank for supplying water at high temperature to the boiler and to collect the return steam from the system. A boiler water feed pump, which supplies and maintains the water level inside the oil-fired boiler. Exhaust gas boiler, an excess heat retrieving system which uses main engine exhaust to generate additional steam. Exhaust gas boiler water circulation pump, which supplies and circulates hot water inside the exhaust gas boiler. Main and auxiliary steam supply. The steam generated is provided to various systems in the engine room for consumption. Steam dump condenser. The excess steam is cooled down by a seawater condenser and the condensed water is then returned to the hot well. This is a general layout of a steam system fitted with an exhaust gas boiler. Now we will move forward to our next section, which is operation of an auxiliary oil fired boiler. Before firing a boiler, ensure that the boiler feed water pump is in auto and the feed water line valves to the boiler are in open condition. Check the water level in the boiler drum through the gauge glass. The gauge glass level should show 3/4 of the water level. Also, the water temperature in the hot well must be maintained between 80 to 85 degrees centigrade. Ensure that the service air to the pilot burner is open. In some systems, the air is supplied by blower line through the pressure control valve. Check all the fuel line valves going to the pilot and main burner are in open condition. Start the fuel oil supply pump and keep it in auto. Ensure that the pressure is in normal range and the fuel oil temperature is maintained as required. Start the blower for at least 3 minutes to purge the furnace. Ensure no dripping of oil take place from the burner. This can be checked by opening the burner door prior to firing. After purging, press the pilot burner firing switch in the panel. This will open the solenoid valve in the fuel line, allowing fuel to go to the pilot burner. After a set period of time, the electrode will get energized and creates a spark. In the presence of fuel and air, a pilot flame will be generated in the furnace. A flame sensor is provided in the burner assembly, which detects the flame and sends the signal to the control panel. If there is no detection of flame by the sensor, a flame failure alarm will be sounded. If there is no flame failure alarm, you will be able to see the pilot flame from the boiler inspection door. Then press the main burner firing switch. This will open the fuel solenoid, supplying fuel to the main burner. With the main blower and fuel pump running, air and fuel are supplied to the main burner. The pilot flame provides the heat source and the main burner ignites. Once the main burner ignites, switch off the pilot burner. If the boiler is started after long shutdown or in cold condition, always follow slow step-by-step firing sequence to avoid thermal stress.